Are you looking for a way to share branded short links for your podcast or your YouTube video or your live stream? Well, you're in the right place because my name is Ileane and I'm with ileanesmith.com. In today's video, I want to talk to you about tools that I use to create branded short links. That's what's coming up, so stay right there. One of the challenges that we face is getting our brand out there and getting recognized and getting people to remember our brand. And we can use different mediums to promote our content. For example, as I mentioned earlier, a podcast. If you're here on YouTube watching now, you may want to promote your brand via YouTube. Or if you're a live streamer, either way, custom branded short links can help you promote your brand because it gives people a memorable link so that they can go and consume your other content or your website or your favorite social media platforms. So let me explain a little bit about the different kinds of short links. There's two types of short links we cover, and the branded versus the generic. A branded short link refers to a URL that is customized around your brand name. So here's a couple of examples. PEP.SI. Okay, you all know who that is. What about Starbucks? They have SBUX.co. Even YouTube has a branded short link, and that's YOUTU.BE. And there's a whole host of other companies and enterprises that use these branded short links. I'll give you my example. Over on Instagram, you know, we can only have that one link in our profile. If, you know, unless you have a business page. So I use the link to my YouTube channel. So to make it easy for people, that's ileane.link/TV. And then that gets people right over here to my YouTube channel. Now, let me tell you the tool that I use to do that. And I'm hoping you heard of this tool before, but if not, I'd like to introduce you to Rebrandly, the easiest way to create and share short links with your custom domain name. And what you do is you actually register that domain name with Rebrandly, and they're very affordable. For example, I got ileane.link for $2 a year. So what you do is you transform these horrible links. And this example they have on the homepage is a really long LinkedIn Pulse article link. And they change it into brand.cool/books. And then you can share that on Twitter, Facebook, Instagram, Pinterest, LinkedIn, of course. And like I said, I really love doing this as a podcaster and as a live streamer, because especially when someone's listening to your podcast, you know, you want to give a link, and it does not always have to go to your content. It could be resources that you're sharing. It could be some affiliate product that you're promoting, but you want people to have an easy way to remember that link, especially, like I said, if you're doing a podcast and maybe they're out and about or they're on the treadmill or they're driving and they won't have time to just pull over and enter your link, but they could remember that quick short link that's branded, because like I said, mine says ileane.link. So let's also show you how Rebrandly has a, well, let me show you the website. Let me show you some of the links that I've created, and just to show you a little bit about how it works. Okay, so here are some of the active links. I'll zoom in a little to make sure you guys can see that. Okay, on my podcast, the one that I have over on Anchor, because I have a few podcasts, but I do have one that's over on Anchor. I put together a video and uploaded it to YouTube. But of course, you don't want to say that really long YouTube link. And in fact, this is an unlisted video. So I know that only the people on Anchor clicked on that link. So I got 7 clicks off of that link, and it shows you how to use Anchor stats. Then I also talked about a service for podcasting called Podcast Guest. And speaking of podcasting, also want to mention International Podcast Day. That's coming on September 30th, and I'll be speaking. It's September 30th every year, so whenever you're watching this, don't worry. Even if you miss the one that just happened, you'll see the one next year. So, and you can always find out by going to ileane.link/day, and that's the International Podcast Day link. So I've used it for other articles that I've referred to and videos that I wanted to talk about, and you can easily track those clicks. The other thing is that it connects to Bitly. So you might have been thinking that I was going to talk about Bitly. Wait a minute, hang on. Let's see what I want to go and show you here. Hold up. Oh, there's a Bitly stats. Hi, Larry's here. Hey, Larry, how are you? Okay, so then now this connects up with Bitly. Now, in the past, I talked about Bitly, and don't get me wrong, I like Bitly as well. But with Bitly, you're kind of using their brand. However, you can take those Bitly links and customize them. But they will be Bitly, so they'll be bit.ly/ whatever it is that you customized it. For example, let's say I took this Anchor one. All right, I want to show you Bitly because I know that a lot of folks use Bitly. All right, and I like Bitly, don't get me wrong. Let's see. I go into edit. And then I would say this one was about an Anchor question over on their support. So I'll call it Anchor support. Here we go. The link has been edited. However, I'll tell you one of the biggest differences with using a Bitly link, besides the fact that it's not your brand, okay, is that it's case sensitive. It's case sensitive. So when you are shouting out a Bitly link, you tell it to somebody, okay, go over to bit.ly/anchor support. They don't know if I capitalize anchor. They don't know if I capitalize the word support. And so that to me is, you know, then you got to tell them all lowercase or capital A, capital, whatever. That's just extra added. It's just not as user friendly because a person may or may not remember. Did they say capital? I'm not sure. I can't remember. Yes. And my friend Larry, who's in the chat, and Larry, I'm going to invite you in. He's talking about pretty links. I use that one too. But the reason why I'm talking about Rebrandly versus that is because pretty links is a WordPress plugin. Now, that's a good thing. Don't think there's anything wrong with that. But I happen to know that everybody doesn't have a WordPress blog. All the folks who follow me, especially on sites like Anchor, who watch my live streams and so forth, they may not have a WordPress blog. And so then they can't use pretty links. So pretty links is a whole nother video, and I may do a video on that as well. The reason I wanted to show you Rebrandly, which is also a lot cheaper than pretty link. Well, pretty link does have a free version, but I use a paid version. But it's only $2. You can find a domain anywhere from $2 to $25. It just depends upon what link you're trying to go after, because some of those, what they call top level domains, TDL, top level domains, are easier to get your hands on than others. And also depends upon what your brand name is.